viewer discretion is advised. The professor then felt uneasy and quickly instructed his assistant to pull the personnel out of the water. But he continued, saying, "And now he swallowed it. Damn, that's gonna haunt my dreams. Wait, it stopped moving. I think it sees me. Oh God, it's looking right at me. Hello everybody, I'm The Rubber. Today, we bring you SCP Foundation Euclid Class Object SCP-1128. SCP-1128, also known as the Aquatic Horror, is an entity that manifests as a massive aquatic predator to anyone given a full description of the being's appearance, through either spoken and written descriptions or visual depictions of the being. Victims infected by 1128 will initially exhibit no abnormal behavior, though some cases show a general aversion to activities involving bodily immersion in water, such as bathing or swimming. If victim ever be fully immersed in water, they will disappear completely under the surface of the water, regardless of the water's actual depth. In most cases, victims will reappear moments later in a panicked state and frantically try to leave the water, while in some other cases, the water will become polluted with blood and debris, confirmed to be the remains of the victim. Victims that have reappeared intact claim that they were transported to a vast ocean, where they are pursued by 1128. Interviews with these individuals carry some risk of further 1128 contamination, as descriptions of the being's appearance trigger further infections. Depends how far along the infection is. At first, it requires full submersion, but over time, it'll take less and less water, until you could step in a puddle and fall in. 1128 infection can be treated with Class C amnestics, as it appears memory of the entity or descriptions of it are required for its anomalous properties to take effect. Testing with infected D-class have shown that wireless communication devices function normally when used by submerged victims affected by SCP-1128. In an experiment, a D-class personnel was instructed to read from a small pamphlet describing 1128's appearance. Then he was outfitted with diving gears, which has a wireless communication device to allow contact between himself and a professor from the Foundation. He was then lowered into a large tub of water via winch and cable. As soon as he hits the bottom of the tub, he told the professor that it looks like he had landed in a patch of seaweed. He started moving around, and suddenly, he saw the scariest thing. The professor refrained him from describing it any further, but wants to know what that thing was doing. "What is it doing?" the professor asked. The personnel replied, "Nothing right now, it's just swimming along. I think it's got something in its mouth. Is that a whale? Holy crap, it is. It's eating a whale. Oh God, look at those teeth." The professor then felt uneasy and quickly instructed his assistant to pull the personnel out of the water. But he continued, saying, "And now he swallowed it. Damn, that's gonna haunt my dreams. Wait, it's stopped moving. I think it sees me. Oh God, it's looking right at me. It's headed this way. Oh God, help me." After a few seconds of hysterical and spouting gibberish, the feed cuts to static. The winch was retracting at full speed when the cable went taut, resting the winch from its mounting. Cable then went slack, and water became polluted with blood, confirmed to be that of the personnel. No further remains or equipment were recovered. Interview log and relevant documents were edited for vectors, and all staff present were treated with Class C amnestics. Tracking devices affixed to D-class personnel used in SCP-1128 experiments reveal that submerged victims are transported to an ocean. After this discovery, one of the doctors asked, "That's where we've been sending those D-class? How does a short-range wireless communicator get such a clear signal from that far away?" Mobile Containment Force MCF Kappa 12 Sea Devils has been assigned to keep unauthorized seafaring vessels out of this area at all costs. MCF Sea Devils has been assigned to intercept and redirect any and all water traffic that passes through their designated patrol area by any means necessary. In one of the testing involving D-class personnel D-1732, who had been used for repeated 1128 testing without administration of amnestics, was shown to be able to encounter 1128 in bodies of water normally insufficient for bodily immersion. This effect became more drastic over time, with D1732 developing progressively stronger hydrophobic tendencies. Claiming to see 1128 from outside almost any body of water encountered by the subject. Days after initial exposure, D1732 was violently pulled into a glass of water. Unfortunately, no remains were recovered from the incident. Staff witnessing the event were found to be infected by 1128 and administered Class C amnestics. Containment procedures were then updated to include videos and descriptions of this event, and testing involving extended infection of D-class was terminated. According to experiment log A2, a D-class was equipped with scuba gear and exposed to 1128, placed into a standard protective shark cage and lowered into water. There was no response for a few seconds. Then the line went taut and was severed at a point beneath the water. Remains of the D-class, as well as jagged steel fragments, presumably remnants of the cage, surfaced shortly afterward. In the next experiment, experiment log A3, the same result occurred. A few hours later, MCF Sea Devils reported to have found an intact shark cage, floating beneath the surface of patrol area near one of their vessels. Item was retrieved and confirmed to match description of cage used in experiment A3. Cage was undamaged, but found traces of human DNA and feces of indeterminate origin. No further remains of D-class found. In another experiment, unlike previous tests, the exposed D-class was equipped with diving gear, armed with a weapon for use against hostile organisms, and was also equipped with a live feed video camera attached to his helmet. Video feed shows that the weapon was ineffective against 1128, appearing only to enrage the creature rather than harm it considerably or drive it away. Feed was lost when D-class was devoured. The staffs involved were treated with amnestics following transcription of video feed. In an experiment to test 1128 manifestation in liquids other than water, an exposed D-class equipped with protective environment suit and video feed was lowered into a vat of substance. This substance was chosen for its low density, allowing free movement similar to walking in open air. Incredibly, the D-class recovered without any incident. The liquid did not trigger 1128's effect. Although you might be safe from 1128 in liquids other than water, but that probably won't help you much unless you intend to drink and bathe in exotic chemicals for the rest of your life, which probably would get a lot shorter if you tried that. Written descriptions and imagery of SCP-1128's appearance or videos of the entity found outside the Foundation are to be destroyed, and Class C amnestics are to be administered to anyone exposed to such information or showing signs of 1128 contamination. A written description of the entity's appearance is to be kept at site for experimental purposes only, and is not to be read by anyone other than D-class used for testing. If exposed, staff are to report immediately for administration of Class C amnestics. Before we end this video, we are proud to present these incredibly sweet pieces of fan art. A big thank you to all of you. You can now send us your fan art, and we will be more than happy to show off your best art piece in our next video. Check out our description below on how to submit. I hope you enjoyed today's video. Which SCP do you want to see in the next video, and why it is interesting? Let us know in the comment below. We will draw your story and share it with the world. Don't forget to click like, subscribe to the channel, and hit the bell. Please share it to your friends if you like this video. Thank you so much for watching, and we will see you in the next video. Bye-bye! Hello, everybody. I'm the Rubber.